Could everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance and the playing of the national anthem? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Good morning, Hollins High, class of 2022. And good morning to all of you here supporting our scholars. We are finally here, the day you have all worked towards. Family, friends, and distinguished guests, my name is Candace Metcalf, Assistant Principal of Curriculum at Hollins High School. We are so honored to have you all with us on this very special day. Please thank Cadet Anthony Hale, who led our Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you, Major Fawthrop, Sergeant Major Rivera, and the JROT cadets for leading us in the Pledge of Allegiance and presentation of colors. Let us also give another round of applause to the Hollins Chamber Choir under the direction of Miss Chelsea Gettner for their rendition of the national anthem. Again, welcome and thank you for joining us to celebrate the accomplishments of our Hollins graduates. At this time, it is my pleasure and honor to welcome and introduce you to the special guests celebrating commencement with us today. If you could please stand when I call your name. First, our scholars. Anastasia Pagano, Senior Class President. Robert Nolden, Student Council President. Daniel Tran, Principal's Choice. Mia Panetta, Salutatorian. And Drayton Brown, Valedictorian. Among our honor guests are our assistant principals, Mr. Eric Zebley, Ms. Nicole Holcomb, and Ms. Ashley Martonic. And we would be remiss if we didn't show our utmost appreciation for our senior class sponsor, Ms. Crystal Rockney, who has contributed a great deal to the success of this graduation and all the incredible senior activities. I am also honored to recognize and welcome the following distinguished guests who are present with us today. Pinellas County Superintendent, Dr. Michael Grego. Area 3 Superintendent, Dr. Dwayne Hines. And School Board Member, Ms. Caprice Edmond. And last, but most certainly not least, the man who has been your morning motivation, gone in 60 seconds and waiting to see you at the top, the very frosty and very proud principal of Hollins High School, Mr. Robert Florio.
All right. Welcome, family, friends, and staff, and students to the 2022 commencements and ceremonies of Hollins High School. I'd like to thank our district leadership team, Superintendent Dr. Michael Grego, who is retiring this year after 42 years of service in public education. Thank you, Dr. Grego. Area Superintendent Dr. Dwayne Hines, our school board, for their continued and sustained support of our school, students, and families. I want to extend a gesture of extreme gratitude to our staff, our team of teachers that have worked tirelessly, endlessly, and persistently on behalf of our students, their families, and our school. To the graduates of 2022, this was a 13-year effort, starting in kindergarten and culminating here today, not as an ending, but the beginning of the life that you will create by the terms you dictate and the way that pleases you. To the grandparents, parents, guardians, friends, all who have helped push, beg, plead, drove you to the finish, we applaud your efforts, your care, concern, your blood, sweat, and tears, and sacrifice, no matter how insignificant or grand, have been invaluable in helping your student make it here today. As a principal, as teachers, we are humbled to have been entrusted with the sacred task of educating your child, a task never taken lightly and made possible by the partnership of cooperation and collaboration. No one successfully goes it alone. And for that, we extend our sincere thanks and gratitude. The class of 22 is unique, a class that had their life education paused as you were rolling through 10th grade. Your spring break became eternal, then virtual, and in some cases nocturnal as you slept through the next year and a half of classes. Smarter and wiser, you're now prepared for life's twists and turns and equipped with the skills to resolve and accomplish tough tasks and big dreams, no doubt about it. The class of 22 continues to build upon the great foundation laid by those who came before and extend our excellence and impact to our great community and country. Over 80% of our class will continue their careers at colleges, university, and armed services. Our Culinary Arts Academy and Entertainment Arts Academy continue to promote outstanding achievement of excellence. Our culinary students have placed in the top three in the state for best wedding cake for 4 straight years. Our students have qualified to continue their education with over $30,000 in scholarships. That's awesome. Our AEA students have placed in the top three in every award they have entered at the district, state, and national level. Senior Mia Spitaro took best in show at the film, animation, and music production at St. Pete College, besting her peers and college students. Our varsity baseball team won the PCAC championship, the district championship, in the same year for the first time ever. Our wrestling team accomplished the same feat and qualified 6 for state finalists. It was the first time in school history we had 2 teams win the both PCAC and the district championships. Awesome. Our JRTC program continues to shine. Senior Anthony Hill led us in the pledge, won the district championship and armed platoon and state championship in male exhibition solo, qualifying for nationals. We designed, constructed, built, and opened a newly imagined and redesigned courtyard with 5 distinct neighborhoods and experiences for our students to go along with one-of-a-kind student center, a world-class AEA facility, and our Culinary Academy's restaurant. Our custom design and promotion business class opened the Hollins House School store is creating, designing, and selling school merch and gear to our public and our students. And finally, This class right here continues the excellence that we started over 5 years ago, and will graduate over 95% of our students that started with us. Good job. Couldn't be more prouder. You are a living testimony to what can happen when hard work and talent converge. Now is the time you move on and continue what you started, using graduation not as the final destination, but a new beginning. Here's my parting message. It's simple and short, at least for me. When I say conceive, believe, achieve, you may have heard me say that. It's not just a slogan. It's a concept in which you live your life and you pursue everything you do. Life is what you make it. You make it great by focusing on the things that you can control, your attitude and your effort. My dad used to always tell me, it doesn't take any special talent to hustle. It is your mindset that controls everything. Your mindset. I'm bringing props. Your mindset. Everybody see that? That's one strong goldfish, isn't it? He believes it, right? Mindset's everything. The most powerful computer in the world is not the gadget that you have in your hands or stuffed away outside so it's not in your hands, right? Were you Tic-Tac, Snapdragon, Instacart your way to more likes to become the world's greatest influencer? The world's most powerful superconductor sits on top of your shoulders, and you program it to what you want in life. The program is perfect. It's infallible. The data you enter, every time, junk in, junk out, quality in, quality out. You act like a winner. You talk like a winner. You respond like a winner. Guess what? You're a winner. You see, there are three types of people in the world. There are accusers, excusers, and choosers. Which one will you be? Your choice will dictate not only your success, but your happiness. The accuser believes it's someone else's fault. Blame someone for their condition, situation, or failure. It's always someone else. The excuser believes if the circumstances were different, if I was smarter, taller, bigger, smarter, had a better teacher, better boss, I would rise to superstardom. They are masters of the woulda, coulda, shoulda, which always equals regret. The chooser, that's you. You understand that life is what you make it. It's a choice. You choose how you will live. You will value what you will do. The chooser chooses to respond positively to life and understands that life will give you what you're willing to accept. The chooser adapts, improvises, overcomes. Expect and accept only your best. Here's a perfect summary of what I'm talking about. A coach once told me the story. He went to see a Toastmaster General event. That's where people learn how to speak and learn about business. And speaking to this group was a captain of finance, Fortune 500 leader, multimillionaire. And the man explained this, that when he was in high school, he was less than the average student, skipping, skating, slipping through the cracks, all the way through his 11th grade year, on the verge of not graduating. He made a promise to his mom that he would take the SAT. You guys remember that test, SAT? Yeah, just some of you have nightmares about it, I get it. You know that test. He showed up on Saturday, took the test, and 3 weeks later, he received the results. I remember opening up my envelope, right? He scored a 1480. So for those of you who don't know, that's a pretty good score. 1600 is the highest. I was praying for four digits, all right? Let's be honest. And if you add up my cumulative career total, I think I'm right about there. So his mom says, like any other mom, 1480, I mean, did you cheat? I mean, how's that possible? He says, no, Mom, I didn't cheat. It was impossible. We were spread out, Scantrans, et cetera. So he says, I guess I'm smart. So his senior year, guess what he does? What changes? His mindset, right? He starts going to class on time. He starts doing his homework. He starts studying for tests. His teachers think, maybe I misjudged him. Start teaching him a little bit differently. So then he goes on to community college, goes on to state college, and eventually gets his MBA from Harvard. End of story, right? Kid doesn't realize he's smart, then he is smart, and then acts like it. The SAT proves that he is. Hold on. 10 years later, married, kids, big beautiful home, he gets a letter from Princeton, New Jersey, which is home of the SAT. He comes home, his wife says, hey, you gonna open this? So he opens it up, he reads it, he says, dear sir, periodically the SAT reviews our practices and audits our scores. The year you took the SAT, we distributed 13 wrong scores to students all over the country. You were one of those students who received the wrong score. 1580, maybe? No. Your score was not a 1480. It was a 740. He said, people think my whole life changed when I got that 1480. Actually, my whole life changed when I started acting like a 1480. His mindset changed. Remember this, class of 2022. Your behavior is way ahead of your success. Conceive, have big dreams. Belief, knowing you can make it happen. Then achieve, having it all come to fruition as you plan. What will change is your mindset. Your past does not predict your future. Use this opportunity that you have as you move forward to today to achieve what you want despite your circumstances. Everyone leaves here today with the same credential, the high school diploma. Not as the last stop on your ride, but the first stop to the rest of your life, where you will achieve goals you set for yourself. I believe that. I believe in you. Stay strong. Stay positive. Stay frosty. Thank you. Love you guys.
Thank you, Mr. Florio. Our next two guests have worked extremely hard over the last 4 years to achieve the highest academic achievements in their class. Please welcome Mia Panetta, our salutatorian, finishing high school with a final GPA of 4.7966.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. My name is Mia Panetta, and it is a great honor to be speaking to all of you as the salutatorian for the 2022 class. You know, when preparing for this speech, I did what any highly academic, top of their class, serious scholar would do. I Googled it. And there were great speech prompts like working hard, overcoming obstacles, shoot for the stars, and the Dr. Seuss quote, "Oh, the places we'll go." But it didn't seem authentic. Because in all probability, I shouldn't even be up here right now giving the speech. There was nothing in my elementary and middle school performance that indicated I would be here. I didn't have high enough test scores to continue my middle school IB program. My teachers suggested I should be held back a grade. And I was behind my peers in reading and math and nearly every other aspect. I didn't feel confident. I didn't feel very intelligent. And certainly not salutatorian material. But what I did have were Friday night movies. It is an institution in the Panetta house. At the end of middle school, my dad showed me the 1976 classic movie, Rocky, and it changed my life. It's about a struggling boxer who wasn't confident, wasn't intelligent. Ring a bell? His life wasn't about working hard and overcoming obstacles. He threw away his boxing skills and referred to himself as a bum. And it was a fluke, really a mistake, that put him in the ring with Apollo Creed, the champ. And that is what I really want to talk about, the thing I know most about, the thing I can speak authentically to, mistakes. My parents say if I was a Care Bear, my name would be Not So Bright. Freshman year, I thought the key to passing my AP exam could be achieved by a Quizlet. And like a 90s sitcom, I stereotypically ran into my parents' garage door with a car that I no longer get to drive. My SATs, what's that saying? Third time's a charm. I took it 7 times. The night before my last attempt, I was binging Squid Games. Because who wasn't? My final SAT score was not impressive. Yeah, mistakes were made. But I've also found the mistakes lead us to where we need to be. It is just part of our journey. Those mistakes are the unforeseen, poorly paved road to our destination. But to make those mistakes, we need to get on that road and try something. And if we don't, well, as Rocky would say, nobody's ever gonna take you serious. You get no respect. That's my best impression, okay? When Rocky was offered a chance at the title, he knew he was going to lose. The thing he wanted to do was just to go the distance, to last all 14 rounds, which had never been done before with Creed. Maybe to prove it to others that he could, maybe to prove it to himself. At any point, Rocky could have said no. He could have hit the snooze button when his alarm went off at 4 a.m. to start training, and he could have quit during round 3 or 4 or 10, but he didn't. And gauging by the many bruises and concussions he suffered, that might have been a mistake too. But he took on the champ, and he went the distance. So what's going to be your Apollo Creed? Starting a small business, going to college, writing a book, becoming a SoundCloud rapper, or inventing the next Among Us game? Find your Apollo Creed and attempt to go the distance. And when all is said and done, and you're standing a little bruised and tired, look back at your many little mistakes and remember they are proof you tried. And be proud. I came in 9th grade with subpar academics and little expectation. Though like Rocky, I stayed focused on going the distance, taking one day at a time. Rocky didn't win his first fight with Apollo, and you may not win your first fight either. But spoiler alert, he does win in the sequel. In closing, let's each find our Apollo, make some mistakes along the way, and go the distance. And maybe a little more. Thank you.
Thank you, Mia. Next, please welcome Drayton Brown, your class valedictorian, finishing high school with a final GPA of 4.8033.
On behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to welcome all faculty, alumni, friends, family, and distinguished guests to the graduation ceremony of Dixie M. Hollins High School, and I stand before you as your 2022 valedictorian. I'll make this short because I know all of us really want to get out of here and enjoy the time with your friends and family, or just go straight back to bed. I will be first to say I was never the smartest in class. I was never the student to finish his work early. And I certainly wasn't always the self-driven scholar to hold school on a higher shelf than having fun. But I will say I had things no one else had, the traits that decided if I was to achieve this amazing title. And that was dedication. The commitment to reading a textbook late in the next morning when I was tired. The responsibility to do what needed to be done before I did what I wanted to do. The will to keep going on when very few believed in me. There's a lot of people in my life who told me to give up, or that I may not like the results, or doubted that I would even get close. Even after everything, I still stand before you today, and with my lesson that I learned through my 4 years. That lesson is, life is simply just not fair. Life will constantly throw everything at you, even at your lowest. I learned that when you reach the top, everyone wants to tear you down. They want to tear down what you say. They want to tear down what you accomplished. They want to always say something bad about you. So you just got to keep walking, and your self-worth has to be strong enough that when everybody's trying to attack you, it's because they want to be you. And the only way they can be you is you that they rip you. There will be times in each one of what one man can do, another man can do. And if that means if one person, one single person on this earth can be a doctor, why can't I be one? If one single person can be an astronaut, why can't I be one? If only one person on the whole earth can do something, who's to say you can't do it too? Absolutely no one. Not a single soul can tell you what you can do with your life. And each one of us graduating here today has a life, and I say make it as valuable as possible. Before I step off today, I would like to talk about the two most important people in my life, one of which is my mom, who pushed me. I most thank you for your passion, to be a fighter who never stops moving forward toward a goal, even if you fail along the way, to find something you're passionate about and never have an off switch. If you want something, simply go get it. Next, I would like to thank the man who raised me, the man who is my best friend and parent at the same time. Dad, we made this happen. Besides school, I want to thank you for raising me into the man I am today by teaching me the power of hard work, to have dignity, to walk my own path, and to take pride in the small things. It's just the two of us, and we can make it if we try. Thank you, class of 2022.
Thank you, Drayton. Congratulations to both Mia and Drayton on your academic efforts and achievements. And now a word from our student leaders. Please welcome Mr. Daniel Tran, our principal's choice.
Thank you, Ms. Metcalf. Charles Darwin once said that it is not the strongest or the most intelligent who will survive, but those who can best manage change. My name is Daniel Tran, also known as the man with the plan, as Mr. Foyer likes to greet me in the car circle. Change is something that my family members and I have all experienced in our lives. Due to poverty that resulted from the atrocities of the Vietnam War, my family was forced to migrate to America in 1990, carrying nothing but a $20 bill with no English ability. From the refugee camps, they found a way to assimilate into American lifestyle, working day in and day out of Asian restaurants to make a living. Even though they were able to find employment, they would be subject to xenophobia. They needed raincoats to travel to work on a bicycle without getting food thrown at them and hence on their clothes. While having to deal with these hardships, my family was able to deal with change. What I would like to bring to your attention today is that change is inevitable in our lives. Therefore, our mission to be successful is to adapt to these changes when they arise. We, the class of 2022, have faced changes ourselves. In the middle of our high school careers, we were faced with the issues of virtual learning and how to wash our hands correctly. Some of us still not knowing how to do so. All change is not progress. However, change in the right direction is progress. The proof is seated in front of you. Over 300 graduates are waiting to be handed their diplomas. While we are able to make it here today, it must be noted that incredible struggle happened along the way. Sickness, stress, and days of sobbing were the backbones of our recent success. One phrase that I will remember is from my favorite teacher, Mr. Carter Waterkeen, who said, "You learn more from tears than hugs." My message to you, class of 2022, is that you cannot escape change in your life, and your purpose is to be able to react accordingly to these unexpected bumps in the road. If there is a moment that you feel like life has knocked you down, you must stay determined as fate has more plans for you. Throughout your life endeavors, you will know it's worth it when you encounter moments of bliss blended in with your hard work. I would like to share with you some lessons I've learned from one of my biggest inspirations in my life, my godfather, George Byron Kenworthy. What I've learned from him is that persistence is imperative to the journey of success, which is followed by growth towards what makes you happy. If you don't love what you are doing, there's no point in pursuing it. By staying resilient through times of adversity, you can be the change that is needed to make it to tomorrow. The door to success is labeled push. You have what it takes to be number one, number two, or number three. Thank you.
Thank you, Dan. Please join me now in welcoming Student Council President, Mr. Robert Nolden.
That was nothing like High School Musical. Fellow classmates, family, friends, and distinguished guests, welcome. Before I begin, on behalf of Class of 2022, I would like to thank Principal Mr. Florio, our assistant principals, and our amazing teachers and faculty, as well as a big shout out to Ms. Rockney for making our senior year amazing, and Ms. Simfe for helping during senior week, and Ms. August for helping throughout the year. I was told not to make this speech long, plus crowds make me nervous, so I'll be fast and furious and gone in 60 seconds. Just kidding, because we know how the word counts work. Right, English teachers? Those 7 to 10 minute talks in the morning for a motivational wake up are going to be something we all miss. But here we are, the day many of us have waited for. For so long is finally here. And it's bittersweet because after we walk across this stage and out those doors, we are no longer students at Hollins High School. We will never sit in third period wondering what's for lunch, whether that be a chicken sandwich or pepperoni pizza, which we all knew would be an option every day. We won't be able to sit with our friends and talk about what we want to do after the last bell rings. We've officially heard our last bell. The teachers we've made connections with will make new connections, as we will do also, whether you make them at the college you chose to go to or the job or career you've decided to do for the next 40 to 50 years. We have created a family here at Hollins, but it is now time for us to create a family of our own outside of those four walls we've been in for 4 years. Well, really 2 years, because we were taken out of school sophomore spring break, and some of us just came back this year for that senior experience. It was definitely an experience many of us will never forget. Those numbers and letters that we believe dictate our lives truly don't, because we are all here in a blue cap and gown getting the same piece of paper. The only difference is the name on that paper. But now, here we are in our hot and sweaty cap and gowns waiting to walk across this stage and walk out those doors into the real world. It's been an amazing 4 years with you. I will always cherish the memories we made along the way. We finally made it to this moment. The last 4 years have prepared us for this exact moment. We are more ready than we believe. See you on the other side.
Thank you, Robert. And to speak to our senior class president, Miss Anastasia Pagano.
Good morning, and thank you all for being here on this incredibly early but marvelous morning. Before I begin, I would like to thank all of the teachers and faculty that have helped make such a spectacular impact on our class of students and have taken it upon themselves to help us reach such a grand finish line. I would also like to thank my family and my friends for the support and guidance received along the way. More importantly, I would like to give a special thanks to my father, who has stuck with me through thick and thin and has never given up, no matter the circumstances. Whether it be giving heartfelt advice or even diving deeper to assist me by looking up YouTube videos to help me aid when I'm at a halt with my homework. Nevertheless, the journey over the last 4 years has been far from easy. But here we are, we made it. Much of the challenging work and dedication has at last paid off. Who would have thought all of those dreadful exams and endless nights of homework would eventually lead us here to this glory-filled day? The amount of growth from my fellow classmates and I have accomplished is quite astonishing. From forming new bonds and relationships with individuals and creating many memorable moments that shall never be forgotten, to now moving on to the next chapter of our lives and making something out of it for ourselves and for our future. For me, that will be attending the University of North Florida and majoring in biomedical sciences, where I'll be one step closer to my future career goal as a plastic surgeon. To keep things short and brief, I'd like to just say, if I could do one thing to leave a message, that would be to change the mindset of the world, embedding within people more kindness, empathy, respect, supported by education that would offer more knowledge and understanding. With that being said, I would also encourage others to believe that no matter what foe says to you, you can do anything you put your mind to. To not be afraid of judgment, to be who you are and step outside that box we all get so comfortable in. to always stay true to yourself, because at the end of the day, we are all of the same. Once again, I want to thank all of you for being here. And as Mr. Florio, our principal, always says, stay frosty.
Thank you, Anastasia.
Ms. Metcalf, will you certify that the class of 2022 has met all requirements for graduations from Hollins High School?
Mr. Florio, these seniors have satisfactorily completed all requirements of law and standard for high school graduation as prescribed by the State Board of Education and the District School Board. I present to you the graduating class of 2022.
All right, let's do this.
Daniel Tran. Drayton Brown II. Mia Janelle Panetta. Robert Nolden. Anastasia Pagano. Brandon Jacinto Garcia. Jasmine Bentley. Cohen Mellenbacher. Jose De Jesus Colazo Salas. Go ahead. Cameron Paul Glass. Ton Hong. Kelsey Parmalee. Emma Shepherd. Taylor Dupree.
Dahlia Duarte.
Dahlia Duarte. Ryan Sullivan. Mackenzie Schoonover. Stephanie Ebersol. Charlotte Rush. Anthony Hale. Anthony Cow. Patrick Lynch. Diana Nathan. Sarah Welker. Joseph Rivera. Thank you. Nicholas Brake. Dale Williver. Antonio Delgado. Shamar Holmes. Ashton Ashley. Temery Murphy.
Jason Massey.
Jason Maceo. Corbett Talbert. Fred Ackley. Myla Corbos. Jackson Eanes. Brennan Jenkins. John Ernst. Rebecca Maidenberg. Jordan Brandenburg. Stephen Cook.
Teresa Maria Corona. Ocean Star Cunningham. Sierra Little. Robert Joseph Went II. Richard Charles Whitfield. Kaya Marie Moses. Kylie Lauren Herbs. Kyle Johnson. Mark A. Stein. John Andres Arroyo. Davin Sebastian Roldan. Davin. Gabriel Sanchez.
DeAndre Rush.
Zachary Justin Hupert. Litton Russell Hanks. Christina Lee Schubert. Desiree Butcher. Sarah Nicole Randolph. Kirsten Annie Matthew. Sienna Jeanette Aronsalt. Maya Elizabeth Puttenow. Shaylin Diaz. Dallas Brenton Webb. Jacob Bernard Green. Jordan H. Jacobs. Kaylee Nguyen. Ken Lynn Nguyen. Tiffany Tran. Ashley Nguyen. Cameron Premis. You have a card? Matai Anderson. Sarah Phyllis Root. Bailey Blasini. Guadalupe Hernandez. Andres Martinez. Kaju Alfred. Tasfia Bouillon. Thomas Richard Loeb. Amaya A. Adams.
Ava Alexander. Elliot Miguel. Julianne Madeline Lim. Kayleen Tran. Madison Ashley Rogers. Haley Hunter. Alessandro DiPaolo. Alessandro Ferciazzi. Jericho Javier. Kylie Niska. Devin Deshaun Johnson. Isaiah Davis. Zamaria Sanders. Autumn Purvis. Skylar Holsklaw. Kaylin Whiting. Ruben Hernandez. Aiden Carr. Tyler Bell. Gene Lopez. Angel Fernandez. Gene Hernandez. Christian Ramos. Melanie Rodriguez. Alexandra Bossert. Alexis Blair. Angeline Melendez. Aaron Branley. Jonathan Smith. DeAndre Sanders. Harry Diaz. Landon Root. Shauna Cole. Timothy Smith. Xavier Strunk. Christopher Morris Jr. Charisse Gillette. Afia Kamal. Xiang Zhao.
Lake Jazz Brainin. Charles DeBrisco. Kevin No. David Thon Pham. Max Gamive. John Lee. Andrew Chow. How do you pronounce it? Aaron Sissonboom. Adon Thompson. Evan Fernandez. Nathan Andrew Stewart. Lark Shaw Stafford. Brandon Alton Lee Barnes. Brenda Bauer. Aisha Barrow. Maya DiAgostino. David Sim. Cyrus Lamb. Rowan Van Alsberg. Quan Din. Odette Martinez. Emily Shea Moore. Saja Musa. Bryce Thomas Hang. Tam Tran. Madison Migueli. Annalise Sophia Nunez. Cameron Gale. Wesley Mansell. Ocean Lakin Edmonds. Mia Ann Spataro. Ariana Spokes. Gabriella Patera Luna. Triet Pham. Sierra Kira Deal. Margot Rufin. Autumn Van Cott. Nathaniel Lawrence Sanders. Jesse James Walden. Zaire Downs. Davidson Antoine. Sebastian Ryan Strong. Renaya Tape. You're good.
Ariana Wilson.
Armaya
Dinkins. Sojuri Korea. Megan Elizabeth Carbonaro. Ariana Elizabeth Rogers. Tayana Wallace. Destiny Love Thompson. Victoria Layard. Alora Rose Fields. Clayton Lee Ross Beatty. Aspen Harvey. Alexander McCallum. Charisma Amick. Tatiana Bell Culata. Dylan Samuel Phillips. Xavier Charles Ball. Aiden Albert. John S. Wallace III.
Say that again.
David John Michael Vongzi Tsepong.
No.
Andre Sayu. Deacon Allen Keen. Dat Lee. Thien Nguyen. Anthony Than Dat Nguyen. Keandre Rucker. Andre Smar. Nathaniel Easterman. Jatavius Marquell Milton. Blaze Juwan Harrington. Agilon Varner.
Let me help you with mine. It's Amiel Francois Gibson.
Amiel Francois Gibson.
Can you say the Hollins legend, then my name?
No.
Please.
Diego A. Davis. Diego.
Say Jordan Truitt the first.
Jordan Truitt the first. Aiden Joseph Iverson. Anna Brown. Shaylee Pereira.
I always mess it up.
Trinity Nicole Miller. Aaliyah Jade Schweitzer. Justin Gibb. Julia George.
Lillian Schaefer. Alex Bauer. Candace Tisdale. Chloe Dorcas. Aiden Maintner. Matthew Faella. Courtney Pucci. Joshua Tai. Donovan Perez. Summer Dreigel. Alicia Miller. Mason Kresek. Benjamin Tessier. Nathan Race. Blue Carruthers. Anissa Gillette. Mia Simone Wilson. Micaiah McCray. Michaela McCray. Devaris Rush. Trey Williams. Sophia Wynn. William Brighton Villers.
Nicholas Zadunchik. Jaden Plumer. Cameron Pezza. Paola Castellano. Vu Quinn Vu. V. Quinn Vu. Araceli Fernandez. Brandon Bannon. Mackenzie Paige Morris. Joshua Robert Hunter. Leslie Ortiz Clemente Jr. Priscilla Gomez. Alejandra Paula Alvarez Ramirez. Andresi Adarmes. Manuel Lopez. Sol Marina Mayorga Guerra. Yao Pham. Alisa Grover. Jessica Ramgadu. Vinay Booth. Shania Alston.
Takoya Monique Gordon. Charles Blue. Tiana Gladys Marie Dunbar. Ken Anthony Lamb. Deasia Murray. Anthony Kiyosakin. Aiden Hornsby. Sabrine Elzine. Rijan Story. Keon Brown. Layson Malloy. Noah Frederick. Angel Thatch. Thomas Mendez. Amanda Garcia. Voshan Baker. Tafari Major. Kyson Brown.
Kimren Jamori Montgomery. Tavion Ashley. Jermaine Martavius Daniels II. Kyle Victor Jennings. Antonio Christopher Faison. Nevaeh Tuttle. Alexis Rose C. How do you pronounce that? Ryan Edward Correger. Fernando Rafael Romero. Megan Anderson. Lena Tu. How do you pronounce it? Hong An Pham Ho. Angelina Touch. Rebecca Nguyen. Anaya Harris. Kiera Tyler. Cassandra Schmidt. Samuel Franklin, Shania Breedlove, Cadence Hunt,
AJ Summerlin, Omari Hinton, sorry, Ashton Roberts, Adam Samuel Myers, John Edward Campbell. Gabrielle Renee Matatis. I said it wrong. Marissa Ashley Newman. Hannah Elizabeth Foreman. Kiera Hatley. Jamie Lynn Barr. Alicia S. Williams. Jade N. Traver. Raymond Gay. Yasmali Roman Diaz. Caitlin Jolie Zimmerman. Kayla Roldan. Jasmine Alvarado. Nathan Armstrong.
Joshua Cushing. Darren Strunk. Lamani Joseph. Trinity Clem. Alec Garcia. Trinity Chanel Severe. Yuzaria Shakur. Haley Kendall. Kevin Cuesta. Vu Nguyen. Kevin Castaneda. Annalise Gonzalez. Sean Kilborn. April Dominguez. Caitlin Touchton. Acklin Jackson. Maria Hours. Lamond Gay. Jason Page. Alexis Mata Juarez. Jonathan Tiscareno.
Dakari Morand. Melina Grace Crowder. Eliana Duran. Donna Islamova. Casey Morris. Alyssa Isabel Ottinger. Georgia Lynn Toby. Shayla Train. Alexia Akers. Eight Moores. Hannah Lowry. Jester Perry. Houston Nicholas Smith. Kim Lynn Strutter. Kaylee Ann Phelan. Jad Pitar. Darren Pitts. And Alexis Kadena Moreno.
Thank you.
Will the graduates of the class of 22 and faculty please rise? As principal of Hollins High School, by the power vested in me from the school board, Pinellas County, State of Florida, I now declare you graduated. Please move your tassel from the right to left. You are now alumni. of Hollins High School. Congratulations. Congratulations. As we conclude this exercise, our honored guests and faculty will lead the recessional, followed by our graduates.
take my hand, follow me, cuz I don't wanna hurt you, but he does. I just wanna see you. Oh, you rain.